morning, students. Today, I'm going to introduce you all with a really interesting topic. But before starting this topic, I would like to check your awareness related to the topic that we had already discussed in our previous class. So, as you all know today, we all are surrounded with many of the living and non-living things around us. So, what we call these things? Substances, materials, or objects. Yes, we can call them substances, materials, or objects. But these substances are made up of?
Some are made up of metals, while some are made up of non-metals.
Exactly. Some of these are made up of metals, while some of these are made up of non-metals. So students, what are the definitions of the term metals and non-metals?
Metals are good conductors of electricity, while non-metals are bad conductors of electricity.
Exactly. Metals are good conductors of electricity, while non-metals are bad conductors of electricity. Now today, give me some examples of metals and non-metals.
Examples of metals: iron, copper, aluminium. And examples of non-metals: wood, plastic, and rubber.
Very good. So what are the physical properties of metals? No? Okay, so well students, today we shall discuss about the physical properties of metals. Okay, so you know what exactly physical properties is? Physical properties in which we can just see the structure of anything and conclude that this is that thing. This is called, or we can say physical interaction. By physical interaction we can conclude the result that this is that thing. So this is called, here we go. Here first of the property is solid at room temperature. You know, all the metals, probably all the metals except mercury, all the metals are solid at room temperature. But when it comes to mercury, the mercury remains molten state at room temperature. Will you ever have seen the iron in the molten form at room temperature?
No.
Obviously, iron is always present in the solid form at room temperature. Okay, coming to our next point, that is density. What exactly density is? Density with respect to water. So students, metals have very high density except sodium or potassium. Sodium and potassium has very low density, so that whenever we put an iron layer in the water, they always float down. Here we have put an iron layer in it and it drops down. And in if we drop sodium and potassium in it, it never drops. It always floats on the surface of water. So today, this is called density of water. Hardness. You know, all the metals except sodium, potassium and lead are very hard in nature. But these sodium, potassium and lead are soft in nature. So we can say that all the metals except few of them are very, very hard in nature. Now coming to our next point, that is malleability. What exactly malleability is? Did you ever see a blacksmith beating a piece of iron with any hammer?
Yes.
So what did you observe? Did you observe the shape after beating it?
Yes, we observed that after beating, it changes its shape.
Yes, after beating any iron piece, it changes its shape. So students, here we can see that a man is beating an iron and it becomes flatter in nature. What it means? It becomes flatter in nature. It means that students, the metals have the capacity to become flatter in nature to become a sheet. We also have an example of that is aluminium foil. We always use it as our kitchen helper. That aluminium foil are made up of metal, aluminium metal, and after beating it, it becomes a thin sheet. So students, this is called the malleability. Now, coming to our next point, that is ductility. Have you ever seen a ductile pipe?
Yes.
Okay. So electric wire. Where we can use this electric wire?
In our household circuits.
Yes, we can use electric wire in our household circuits. What is the function of electric wire?
It flows electricity.
Yes, electric wire conducts electricity. Have you ever seen any electric wire that is made of rubber, plastic or wood?
No.
No. Because electric wires are generally made up of metals. Okay? So it is the property of metal in which we can melt metal and roll it into thin wires or fine wires. Okay, students? Now coming to our next point, that is good conductor of electricity. So students, metals, if we make the electric wires with metals only, it means they have good conductor of electricity. Now coming to our next point, here I didn't have written it, but you have to note that point, and that is saunders. A metal always produces a ringing sound. There is one another property, that is lustrous. What is lustrous? You know, the surface of any metal have its shiny surface. Here, we have two of the substances. What did you observe? Did it have a shiny surface?
Yes.
It has a shiny surface. And what kind of surface it has?
Dull surface.
Dull surface. It means students, metals always have a shiny surface and non-metals always have a dull surface. Move to first slide, please.